Now, that is surely much worse than just saying the F word, right? Anyway, that is going to do it for this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you have, like and subscribe, and click the video on screen for even more content from me. As always, I'll be here, same place, same time tomorrow with more Reddit videos.
New Liquid IV powdered hydration for kids. Bursting with kid-friendly flavor. 50% less sugar, 3 times the electrolytes than the leading sports drink. Packed with 5 essential vitamins. Hydration for kids. Just that enough. Find Liquid IV powdered hydration for kids.
Welcome back to the channel and some more entitled parent stories. Let's get right into them. Let my 9-year-old use your $15,000 lawnmower. So a little backstory. My father and I run a landscaping company with commercial grade lawnmowers that cost somewhere around 12 to 15K. And we run a very large church in a sort of sleazy area of the city, which is also a Catholic school during the day. The kids that are in this school are some of the most misbehaving and out of control kids in all our commercial and residential properties. While mowing the church on a Friday, which is the day we are scheduled to mow on, I was mowing the backyard while my dad was in the front. All of a sudden, I turn around the building again, and suddenly there are around 30 kids ranging from first to eighth grade, running around outside while I'm mowing. The bagger is off on this door, which means if I hit a rock with the blades running, a small little rock becomes a projectile and can seriously hurt one of those kids. Obviously annoyed, I hop off the mower, turning the blades off first, and went to go talk to the principal, who we've spoken to about the issue many times, and she is the parent to one of the kids. The situation happened as followed. Excuse me, Mark, can you please keep the kids inside while we are here mowing? Why do you law guys complain about everything? We are just asking you to please keep the kids inside so they don't get hurt on accident. Then just don't mow while we're outside. We've been mowing this lawn for a year, and this is the day we're assigned to mow by the pastor. I don't care, he's not here, so I'm in charge. All of a sudden, out of the corner of my eye, I see a kid no more than 9 years old climbing onto my tractor. I then sprint towards the kid. Excuse me, can you please get off my tractor?
No, I want to play on the big machine.
Please, get off the tractor. That doesn't belong to you and is dangerous for a kid. Then I heard,
do not talk to my baby like that.
Turns out the kid was none other than the principal's son. Please have your son get off my tractor. It isn't, but the principal cuts me off. Don't tell me how to raise my child. At this point, I'm getting red in the face to the point of steam coming out of my ears while trying to keep my composure. This is a $14,000 machine, and a 9-year-old shouldn't even be allowed near it. I said, pulling out the key so the kid couldn't try to do anything.
Turn on the big machine.
Give me that key now. And why would I give you the key?
Because I said so.
You're a kid and I'm an adult, so listen to your elders now. Mind that I'm 21 years old. Mom, I'm going to ask one more time to remove your son from my tractor. Give me that key now. At this point, my dad comes over, wondering why I haven't finished, and brought the mower over to him to switch off yet. Mind that my dad is not as polite as I am, and when it comes to money and his expensive equipment, he does not F around. I explain the situation, and what happens next is priceless. Who the F do you think you are? The principal is taken aback. That tractor is worth $15,000, and you think it's okay to let a kid play on it? At this point, the kid was so scared of my dad's yelling that he ran into the crowd of kids that had gathered around. Get those kids inside until we're done so that no one gets hurt. What transpires next doesn't really matter, but it ended with two teachers calming the situation and the kids going inside. The next week, we go back to mow again, and the pastor came and talked to us, apologizing profusely. The way the whole situation went down was probably not the best language to use in front of young kids, and my dad apologized for that. But
yeah.
the entitled mum gets involved. Excuse me, that's our food. My mum says, no, it isn't real. Yes, it is our food. Waitress chimes in, no, mom, this is their food. They all get to the table number 12. You are table number 10. I don't care. If they give me the food, I'm going to your manager. By this point, the whole restaurant is staring at this menu. Mom, I own this restaurant. Please stop pestering the customers or I'm going to ask you to leave. Goes into full rage mode, screaming at the waitress. Alright, mom, I'm afraid you're gonna have to leave the restaurant, and we will have to call the police.
But we haven't finished our drinks!
Don't think you should treat me the best. That's it, I'm leaving. Have a good night. She left, and the waitress gave us the meal for free because of the inconveniences. We actually saw her screaming at someone else after we left the restaurant, too. Dude, what was going through her mind as that happened? Oh, I didn't order any food, but this food I did order is now mine. Like, what the heck? I don't believe in thinking is this entitled mother's choice. Anyway, that's been good for this one. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, like and subscribe for more Daily Reddit content. Also, click the video on screen right now for some more entitled parents. Welcome back to the channel. Today I've got some more r/ entitled parents stories for you. Now guys, before we get into the stories, I just want to remind you that I do now have merch available. The hoodies, t-shirts and hats are on the screen now. It's really great quality and the link is in the pinned comments. So if you are a big fan and want to support the channel, I would massively appreciate you going and checking it out. Anyway, on to the story. Starting with this one. Entitled parent ignores my warnings about a book series for her daughter. Then about the series being inappropriate. Hi all, a friend of mine introduced me to these types of summoners recently, and I am hooked. It's a running joke among some of my co-workers and friends that I have a face that attracts the phrases. Entitled parents, choosing beggars, for whatever reason they seem to flock to me. I have so many good stories that I can't wait to share with you guys. Well, let's get into one right now. I used to work in a large scale bookstore. It was common for parents to come in and ask recommendations for their children, nieces and nephews, and they usually were extremely begging for help. It was a slow night when in walked Amy. Now, it's been about 2 years since this happened, and I can still clearly see her walking into the store. I'm thinking to myself that it was going to be one of those interactions. Dark brown or black hair in a standard parent do. Shoulders set in pure entitlement and that expression of saying, you know the look, you're a reasonable worker, and I'm excited. where there was manga that was more suitable for your daughter's age. No, you're trying to stop me from buying. Can I speak to someone else who actually knows what they're talking about? Joke's on that entitled parent.